ولكن تحديت الظروف وخضتها وحدي صبورا مستعينا بالصلاة.
كم مرة عصف الأنين بداخلي، كم مرة قد ذاق قلبي من أسى محنتها، وكم كرهت مصابها.
So as you can see on screen, we got the book At-Tamhid by Ibn Abdul-Barr, and it's got narration by Nu'aym bin Hammad, okay, that in relation to the hadith of the Nuzul, which is a refutation of the Jahmiyyah, what did Nu'aym say? That he descends bidhatihi. And Nu'aym bin Hammad, the teacher of Imam Bukhari, that he mentioned, yanzilu bidhatihi. Ibn Abdul-Barr, okay, underneath, okay, being transparent, he basically doesn't agree with this in terms of the particular phrases. And he's saying that if you say this, you're talking about the kayfiyyah. You understand? So if you say yanzilu bidhatihi, you're talking about the kayfiyyah. It's been used by many of the salaf. Ibn Abdul-Barr doesn't agree with that. But what does Ibn Abdul-Barr mention in his tamhid? He says, as for Ahli Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they are unanimous in affirming, doing iqrar bisifati, and what has been mentioned, all of it in the Quran and the Sunnah, and having iman upon it. And we carry this ala al-haqiqati, la ala al-majaz. We take this literally, not metaphorically, okay? And we don't ask for the highness of any of it. And we don't restrict it, you know what I'm saying? We don't restrict it, etc. And as for Ahlul Bid'ah, Wal-Jahmiyyah, and the Mu'tazila, and all of them, and the Khawarij, all of them deny it, okay? And they don't carry anything of it upon its haqiqat. They don't carry upon it ala al-haqiqati, okay? And they allege that whoever, listen to this, keywords, and they allege that whoever affirms them is a mushabbiha. He is from the mushabbiha. As you can see, we've got the risala too, and they call him Malik al-Saghir. He's a small Malik, giving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, the all knowledgeable, the one that's informed, the one that all administrates, the one that's etc. etc. The hearing, the seeing, and the most high. And what say? Wa annahu fawqa arshihi al-majid bi dhatihi. That he is above the arsh, his majestic arsh, with his essence. Wa huwa fi kulli makanin bi ilmihi. And he knows everything with his knowledge, etc. etc. Now, as you can see, we got the book Najatul Khalaf fi I'tiqad al-Salaf. Okay, and this is by al-Sheikh al-Allamatu Uthman bin Ahmed bin Sa'id al-Najdi. Imagine, وَمَنْ أَرَادَ إِثْبَاتِ الْجِهَةِ الْعَدَمِيَّةِ وَأَرَادَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ وَحْدَهُ فَوْقَ الْمَخْلُوقَاتِ بَائِنٌ عَنْهَا فَهَذَا حَقٌّ. Subhanallah, listen to this. That whoever intends and affirms a jihat al-adamiyah, meaning a direction that is non-existent, but in a terms of the dunyawiya perspective, Allah's above in a manner that befits him, but Allah's above, but not in a sense where it's a jihad that's, you know, restricting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You understand? In a dunyawiya perspective, and affirms Allah is one above his makhlukat, separate from his creation. So this a jihad al-adamiyah is separate from his creation, separate. Okay, remember that he's in a direction of above, but this direction is ba'inun min khalqihi or ba'inun anha. It's separate from his creation. He's above, but in a jihat al-adamiyah. I know it's very technical. And this is fahada haqqun. This is haqq. Okay? This is what? Haqq.
ليس الغريب غريب الشام واليمني إن الغريب غريب الأحد والكفن إن الغريب له حق لغربته على المقيمين في الأوطان والسكن سفر بعيد وزاد لي يبلغني وقوتي ضعفت والموت يطلبني ما أحلم الله عني حيث أمهلني وقد تماديت في ذنبي ويسترني تمر ساعة